Hello guys, welcome back to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can fix the AI in the new first-person shooter game template, and also how you can customize and swap out things like the weapon and character meshes. And if you're new here to the channel, my name is SmartPaul, and I make all sorts of Unreal Engine news and tutorials, so don't forget to leave a like on the video, subscribe, and without further ado, let's get right into the video. So first things first, to fix the AI, as you can see, if we hit play here, the AI aren't really chasing the player or attacking us. We can shoot at the AI, but you can see it does basically nothing. So in order to fix it, you just want to right click and click edit the shooter AI blueprint. And over here, you want to search under the details for controller. And under the AI controller class, you want to change this from AI controller to the BP AI controller over there and hit compile and save. Now, if we go ahead and hit play, you can see that the AI actually chases us and shoots at the character. So you can see that it actually killed us. Let's go ahead and respawn and we'll actually be able to fight the enemy AI. So that is how to fix the enemy AI character. So in order to actually swap out the meshes and add our own custom meshes, I'm going to be using the Military Weapon Dark Pack, which I'll leave as a free download in the description below. So once you go ahead and download these two asset packs, as you can see, we have them downloaded right over here. You want to open your project and right-click the content folder and do show in Explorer. That will pull up where it's installed on your hard drive. And then you just want to go ahead and take the Military Weapon Dark character, drag and drop it in there, and drag in both the Military Character and Weapon Dark folders into your content folder, just like so. And now with those new folders installed, we should have the access to the new character meshes. So we have this female character, as well as this male style character over here. And we also have these different weapons in this Military Weapon Dark folder. So we can go ahead and start swapping out the meshes. So I'm gonna go ahead and right click and edit this BPFP Shooter AI. And if we select this character mesh, we can go ahead and swap this out under the detail. Under the mesh, we can swap this with the character. But as you see, if we actually swap it, it's going to look very distorted. So we'll go ahead and just actually retarget the animation. Let's go ahead and control undo that. So you want to browse to the animation class. In our case, the anim class is this ABP TP rifle. So if we browse to this, here it is in the content browser. So we can right click and click retarget animations. And so we're going to select the target mesh and select the one of the characters that we'd like. I'm going to select the ABP TP rifle and click export animations. And it'll ask you to export it to a folder. So I'll just do the Military Weapon Dark folder, click export. And we should have all the animations, including the blueprint, retargeted. So go ahead and do a file, save all. Then let's go ahead and select this. And in here, let's assign this to that character. So I believe I use the female character. And then we'll assign this to the ABP underscore TP rifle. So this bottom one over here, just like so. Let's compile and save that. And now if we hit play, we can see that the character is fully animated. But we'll need to go ahead and fix and add the socket because you can see the gun isn't attached to the character's hand at all. It's just floating down at their feet. So in order to fix that, let's just go ahead and go to the content folder, mannequins folder, under the SK mannequin, double click, open this up. We should have a socket for the hand R and hand L grip. So let's just go and under the female character, let's head over to the skeleton over here. And we can preview an animation. So if we preview the rifle idle aim down sight, we can select the right hand and add a new socket. We're going to copy the same name as the mannequin, which I believe it's called hand R grip. So go ahead and copy and paste that like so. And right click that, we can add a preview asset. So say let's select this rifle over here and just rotate this. And to turn off the snapping, you can select over here under the rotation snapping, we can turn that off and also turn off the grid snapping. So when we press W, we can move it without any grid snapping. We can also rotate it smoothly like so. So I'm just going to position this in the character's hand, just like that. So now that we have that socket set up, let's go ahead and save that and hit play. And now we should see the actual rifle in the character's hand properly attached like so. Now to actually go ahead and swap out things like the weapon meshes, we'll need to go ahead and modify the weapon blueprints. So let's go into the first person blueprints pickups, and under the rifle, we'll go ahead and open up the BP weapon rifle. So open the full blueprint editor and head over to the viewport. And we should be able to select this skeletal mesh asset and swap it out for the assault rifle B. Okay. And also we need to select the third person weapon mesh. Also do the same exact thing and swap this out with the assault rifle B. So compile and save that. And also we can do the same thing for the pistol. So let's head over to the pistol, open up the BP weapon pistol, open the full blueprint editor, head over to the viewport and select this weapon. And let's go ahead and swap out the mesh for this pistol B. Same thing with the third person mesh. Let's go ahead and swap that out for pistol B. Compile and save that. And also to update the pickups, so these little pickup spawner weapons, you need to browse to it and it'll show you where it's at in the content folder. But we have this data table for weapon list. So if you double click and open this up, this has the reference to the blueprint as well as the mesh that should be spawned. So we need to swap these out. So under the rifle, we'll need two changes to the assault rifle, but currently this is only allowed for static meshes, meaning we'll have to quickly export a static mesh. So head over to the weapons folder, open up the assault rifle B, just make a static mesh and put this in our weapon dark, click save. And also we'll do the same thing for the pistol. So open that up and do make static mesh. This will be our pistol and save this in the weapon dark. And now we should have those two static meshes. So we'll just go ahead and rename this to rifle and just do file save all. So in that data table, we can go ahead and assign those. So we have the pistol mesh. We can assign this to the pistol like so. And we have the rifle. We'll assign this to the new rifle mesh. So save both of those. And now let's hit play. And now we should see the new pickups be updated to the new weapon mesh. So we can go ahead and pick this up. And you can see that the characters are also using those brand new weapon meshes as well. So we have this pistol over here. Now we can shoot and kill the enemy AI. So it looks like there's no enemy AI spawner in here. So this is just using the classic placed in the level AI. So we can go ahead and duplicate a couple more of these if we'd like by just holding Alt and dragging. So we just have a couple of more AI agents in here that we can fight. But yeah, that is pretty much it for this video. I just wanted to make a quick tutorial to show you how you can swap out things like the weapon mesh and character meshes in this first person template, and also how you can fix the AI blueprint. Let me know what you guys think about this tutorial down in the comments down below, and also let me know what future videos you'd like to see here on the channel. And with that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video.